Removal of INA 212A6C1 bar plus H-4 visa grant equals a true success story. A U.S. consulate granted the H-4 spouse visa to her client after agreeing to remove the INA 212A6C1 charge against her. This permanent bar was made 10 years earlier when she applied for an immigrant visa sponsored by her prior U.S. citizen spouse. A 212D3 non-immigrant waiver is the more common fix, but does not get rid of the bar. In this case, I advise the applicant to file a motion to reconsider and rescind the inadmissibility charge instead of ask for a 212D3 waiver with the visa. The facts and law did not support the consulate's finding that she used fraud or willfully misrepresented material facts to obtain a U.S. immigration benefit. So what was the problem? An INA 212A6C1 charge is a permanent bar that never expires. In the CR1 immigrant visa refusal, the U.S. consulate found that my client had willfully misrepresented material fact in her prior request for a K3 non-immigrant visa. The K3 allows a spouse of a U.S. citizen to enter the U.S. with temporary status and then apply for a green card through Form I-45 adjustment. According to the consulate, she had falsely claimed to be married to the U.S. citizen petitioner when she really was not. It reasoned that her Hindu marriage, at the time she applied for the K3 visa, was not legally valid because their marital ceremony did not include the statutorily recognized rituals, saptapadi and agniferas. The couple chose to leave out these rituals for personal reasons. They received a marriage certificate from the government authorities based on the ceremony that was performed. They did not expect the U.S. consulate to question the validity of the marriage due to the missing ceremonial rituals. At the K3 visa interview, the consular officer instructed the applicant to complete a new marital ceremony with all the necessary Hindu marriage rituals. It issued a visa refusal notice stating the petition was invalid and would be returned to USCIS for revocation. After following the consulate's instructions, the U.S. citizen filed a second I-130 petition to restart the process. The beneficiary later applied for the immigrant visa with the understanding that the new marriage met the consulate's requirements. Instead of granting the CR1 visa, the consulate denied it under INA 212A6C1. The consulate found the applicant had lied about her marital status in the K3 visa request because she did not have a legal marriage to the petitioner at the time. She next filed a Form I-601 application for waiver of inadmissibility with USCIS as instructed by the consulate. A year later, the I-601 waiver request was denied. USCIS found there was insufficient evidence of extreme hardship to the U.S. citizen petitioner if the applicant did not immigrate to the United States. The separation led the marriage to fall apart and end in divorce. Several years later, the applicant entered into a legal bona fide marriage to an H-1B visa holder. The couple then contacted me for help in getting the H-4 visa at the U.S. consulate. I confirmed that Section 212A6C1 is a lifetime inadmissibility bar. The H-4 visa could be granted only if the U.S. consulate agreed to remove the bar or the U.S. Customs and Border Protection Admissibility Review Office issued a 212D3 waiver with the consulate's recommendation. So what remedy did we use? A motion to reconsider and rescind inadmissibility bar in the H-4 visa request. With my guidance, the couple decided to ask the U.S. consulate to remove the Section 212A6C1 charge and grant the H-4 visa without requiring the 212D3 waiver. To support the motion to reconsider, I counseled the H-1B spouse and the H-4 applicant on the written testimonies and documentary evidence to present to the consulate. I also prepared a legal memorandum explaining why the Section 212-6C1 bar did not apply to this case. At the visa interview, the applicant was questioned about the prior marriage that led to the inadmissibility bar. To show the consular officer that the bar was made in error, she presented the motion to reconsider including my legal memorandum and her affidavit. The consulate accepted her documents and placed the case in 221G administrative processing. After receiving my follow-up inquiry, the consulate scheduled the applicant for a second interview. This was 3 months after her first interview. She answered more questions on her marriage to the H-1B visa holder. She also submitted more evidence related to the marriage in response to a second 221G notice. 6 months after the first interview, the consulate issued a notice stating the applicant was eligible for a 212D3 waiver. I then followed up with the consulate requesting again they review the motion to reconsider and lift the section 212-6C1 bar. After several more months of administrative processing and follow-up inquiries, the consulate issued a notice stating a new waiver was in process because the prior waiver had expired. At that point, I filed a request with the Visa Office, U.S. Department of State, asking it to counsel the U.S. consulate to reconsider the inadmissibility charge instead of require a 212D3 waiver. The Visa Office contacted the consulate and began to investigate my inquiry. So what was the outcome? A removal of the misrepresentation bar and H-4 visa grant. A year after the applicant had attended her first H-4 visa interview, the U.S. consulate finally agreed to remove the Section 212-6C1 bar. The Visa Office sent me an email stating the consulate would contact the applicant with further instructions on her H-4 visa request. Despite the long wait, my client was happy to have the bar lifted and to receive her H-4 visa without needing a 212D3 waiver. The visa was marked with a clearance received annotation. Because her spouse was already in the U.S. in H-1B status, she was exempted from Presidential Proclamation 10052, which placed COVID-19 travel restrictions on non-immigrant visa applicants. With the removal of the 212-6C1 charge, my client will not need a 212-T3 waiver to extend her H-4 status or to get a new non-immigrant visa. She also will not require an I-601 INA 212I waiver to immigrate to the U.S. with her husband, who may apply for permanent residence through his U.S. employer. The H-4 applicant, her spouse, and I communicated by emails and telephone calls. I had one in-person meeting with the H-1B spouse for the initial consultation. With effective collaboration, we convinced the U.S. consulate to remove the 6C1 bar, which was made a decade ago, and grant the H-4 visa. This is a true success story at Dyan Williams Law. This is general information only. Do not consider it as legal advice. Each case is unique. Even cases that seem similar can have different outcomes. Have you ever been charged with fraud or willful misrepresentation and have a 6C1 bar? If you're applying for a non-immigrant visa, you will need a 212D3 waiver. Otherwise, if the bar was made in error, you might be able to get it removed. To receive legal advice on fraud or misrepresentation issues, contact us through our website at dianwilliamslaw.com.